नमस्कार, गुड इवनिंग टू एवरीवन। वेनरेबल महासंघ, मिस्टर चंद्रकांत भंडार, हु इज द मेन ऑर्गेनाइजर ऑफ दिस इवेंट एंड द एडिटर ऑफ यात्रा न्यूज़पेपर, एंड मिस्टर बनापुल बरुआ, हु हैज टेकन अ ग्रेट रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू ऑर्गेनाइज दिस इवेंट, एंड लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, चिल्ड्रन रिप्रेजेंटिंग Sri Lankan, Bangladesh, Indian, Canadian communities here. I am indeed happy and honored to say a few words before this wonderful and esteemed gathering, and I am thankful to Mr. Chandran Bandar, the editor of Yatra newspaper, with the again main organizer of this event, for inviting me here. In this evening, Mr. Bandar has given me a task to accomplish. By the way, it is a daunting task. Absolutely, it is a challenging task. In this evening, he asked me to give an introduction on Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore and to say something, a humble effort to do that. Please forgive my ultra generalizations. First of all, I am thankful all the artists who sang before, such intoxicating voice. I never heard Bangladeshi music through that kind of voice. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And whenever I delivering speeches, as a habit, I do not follow any script. But again, Mr. Bandar asked me to submit my speech in advance. So I am following today a script, but definitely I will add something as exceptions. Today, Mr. Bandar and Mr. Barua has created a meeting point for Bangladeshi Sri Lankan communities. Decades ago, Rabindranath Tagore also created a meeting point somewhere in Berlin, where the Western science and the Eastern spirituality met together. He met great scientist Albert Einstein. Moment ago, we showed the slides and the first photograph of he was sitting with Einstein. And there was a big argument went on. The historic discussion of epistemology and ontology, everything. Yes. So if you have a time, please go through then that historic discussion. In the same manner, so we are again creating in the West a meeting point where we encounter the beauty, strength of Eastern spirituality. So the tower and figure of that spiritual path is Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was one of the towering leaders of the India's independence struggle. But he didn't live to see an independent India. At the age of 80, he passed away in 1941, remaining a huge heritage, not only for the people of India and Bangladesh, but for the entire world. That is a world heritage. Start from poetry to politics. Environment to spirituality, philosophy to arts, nationalism to internationalism or universalism, activism to relaxation. From a simple ditty to national anthems sung by millions of people. From education to enlightenment. From a dewdrop to a rain. From rain to whale. From whale to river. From river to ocean. Tagore has been an inextricable personality, an irrevocable bond, a long-lasting memory, and a cultural treasure that you can't dig up and finish in your lifetime. Above all, for me personally, Tagore is a poet. His language was figurative, expressive, and so evocative. He was known mostly for his literature works. He was the first non-European personality to win the Nobel Prize for his remarkable poetry, the Gitanjali. When Mr. Bandara asked me to say a few words in this gathering, I was compelled to reread Gitanjali again. So thank you, Mr. Bandara, for that. He wrote novels, to name one, Gora, essays, short stories, dramas, and many thousand songs. Some of them we heard a moment ago. Thousand songs. They were rhythmic. Not only songs, even novels were rhythmic. Prose, short stories, all had a rhythmic style. And they were philosophical, progressive, spiritual, and simple. He had unlimited devotedness for humankind, especially for ordinary people. To quote, can a single link in on? Polava Kotanatana Par Tananatana Giniam Awe Mahavaru Savi Devio Vedavin. He is with them in sun and shower, where the tiller is tilling the hard land and pathmaker is breaking stones. That is his devotedness for ordinary people. He saw the God with them. So my subject is more into politics. I have to say something about Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore's politics. His contribution for India's independence was widely known. He associated himself with Mahatma Gandhi, and this is very important. He refused the knight name given by the British government, then British government in India, in order to protest the Amritsar massacre. So he gave it back for British people. Such a brave person. He was a fighter. And in the same manner, he was a peacemaker. He mediated a big dispute occurred between Mahatma Gandhi and Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. Otherwise, it would have prompted a big calamity in India. Mahatma Gandhi only listened to Rabindranath Tagore, then stopped his hunger strike. And many of his songs, it played a back role of India's independence struggle. Some believe that he supported Subhash Chandra, I don't know personally, some believe that he supported Subhash Chandra Bose. According to them, his famous song, Dakshune Kyu Naase Ekla Chalo. I can't sing like Bante Sarnapala. I am not a singer. You're a beautiful soul. Dakshune kyu na ase ekla chalo. Go alone. Based on Khagga Visana Sutra. Ekeni khanga vene kwage yandakala kiyanne baya nathu. Tamange adahasak thiyenona khanga vene kwage palaya. That's what Rabindranath Tagore told all of us. Ekla chalo. So that was kind of spiritual and motivational song behind India's independence struggle. I have given a topic for my this speech. That is from a small ditty to national anthem. You know what is ditty? Gee singit. Tagore wrote many ditties, very small songs, but up to national anthems of millions. The both national anthems of India and Bangladesh were written by Tagore, that's known. India's national anthem is a very short poem. But it covers, actually it is a first part of a long song. It covers whole India. Moment ago we saw India's national anthem sung by very renowned artists like who are there? Bhimsen Joshi, Jasta, Pandit Jasraj, Asha Bhosle, Rashid Khan, Bala Murali Krishna, Lata Mangla, I can't remember. Many artists sang. How beautiful that song. Janagana Mana Adhinayaka Jaihe Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindhu Gujarat Maratha Dravid Uchala Vanga Vindhya Himachal Yamuna Ganga Uchala Jaladi Taranga Tavasubha Name Jahe Tavasubha Ashisha Mahe. Such a beautiful song. It covers the billion people living in India. So it was, whenever we sing, in play that national anthem, Tagore is come to live with us. I'm sorry, I can't sing, I can't give the wording Amar Sonar Bangla. That was another very beautiful national anthem written by Tagore. Sri Lanka's national anthem, Sri Lanka Mata Apa Sri Lanka. It was not written by Tagore. It was written by Ananda Samarakorn. Ananda Samarakorn is a great student, disciple of Tagore. Ananda Samarakorn, actually he sacrificed his whole life to popularize the Rabindra Sangeet in Sri Lanka. So then there is a connection to Sri Lankan national anthem also from Tagore's heritage. So that is the story of national anthem. So it is started by Rabindranath Tagore. The visits of Rabindranath Tagore prompted many Sri Lankans music lovers to follow Rabindra Sangeet. Ananda Samarakorn, Sunil Shant, Edwin Samaradivakar, Surya Sankar Mollikota, W.D. Makololuwa, Lionel Edirisinghe, G.R. Redbird, Ananda Jayasinghe, Lionel Algama were among them. These personalities were some of pioneers of modern Sri Lankan music. Hence, Tagore belongs to Sri Lanka in a bigger way. I do not speak Bengali or Hindi. I read Tagore through Sinhala and English translations. I would like to conclude my speech in bringing your attention towards one of Tagore's poems, which has been translated into Sinhala. In Bengali, it's called Chito Jeta Bai Shunyo. What is the meaning of that? Chito Jeta Bai Shunyo. The Gitanjali says like, where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where the world come out from the depth of truth, where the tireless striving stretches in arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into desert sand of dead happy, where the mind is led forward by the ever-winding thought and action into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. The Sinhala version starts with the second line of that poem, goes to the rest of the poem like this. Patu adahas nam paurin loke kabali valata nobedi, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Patu adahas nam paurin loke kabali valata nobedi, bien torawa hisa kelin tebagena sitinata haki kohedu eu nidahase swarga rajyayata mage deshaya avadhi karanu mena piyanani. And then again he says, where words come out from the depth of truth. Words come out from depth of truth. Satyaya patulen galana pirisudu vachana kohida ætti. Gatanu gatikava pavetena sirite maru katarata vedila nirmala jaladharava tarke sindi bindi noyede. Eva nidahase swarga rajyayata mage deshaya avadhikaranu mena piyanani, where the mind is led forward by the into ever widening thought and action, pasu nobasina veeriya pirupun bava desata dasa vidaha sada divunuwana situvili udesa kam katayutu karana idiriyatama oba maasita yomawa atte kotenata do eva nidahase swarga rajyayata mage deshaya avadhikaranu mena piyanani. So decades back, we had our leader, we had our philosopher, we had our guru, we had our spiritual path designed by Rabindranath Tagore. What else in the name of heritage we need for this world? So such a great personality, we are having a memorial gathering today. So Mr. Bandara, who is very much sensitive, journalist, community leader here, had done a correct thing at the correct time, I guess. So I am told that Mr. Banapul Barua, he has a wonderful name, so Banapul. Banapul, according to Sarnapala Hamaduru, it is Vanamala. Vanapasamala. කියනවනේ වන් පරසතු මලින් පුද ලදමුනි සඳුට දියනද වනපස මලින් පුද කලයි පවසනු කවර වරදද බුද්ධ වස් offered by flowers of heaven, but it is no harm to offer him some flowers from jungle. So it's a good name, Vanapasa Mala. He has written a novel also called Vanapasa Mala, Vanasapu Mala. Yes, I am. So anyway, so we are very much thankful, Mr. Barua, for bringing creating wonderful event for us. So, on behalf of the government of Sri Lanka, I would like to extend my profound gratitude to you all, Bangladesh community, who had gathered here. So, I think we are yet to listen to more songs, including Ekna Chalo, Ekna Chalo. So I think I should remain at this juncture. Thank you very much for listening to me. Have a nice evening. So thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Bandara.